What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Tom Quigley, bringing the latest tips, tricks and techniques for your contemporary painting and drawing needs. And welcome back to another video. It must be about 6 months since I last did my last video, which has absolutely flown by. And all I can do is apologise for you the absence of content. Do my best to keep on reeling them out. Now, Happy New Year for everybody. It's not the greatest start as a teacher or a student that we could have asked for. And a lot of students are working at home remotely. So this video is going to help those students out and hopefully give you the best possible remote art education that you can have. See you in a minute. What these videos can be based on, I hear you ask. Basically, I want students at home to take ownership of their own project. And what I'm going to do is try and guide you through all the key ingredients that are needed to produce a good project with a final piece at the end of it. From past experience, I know a lot of students sometimes think that art is all about just producing a big piece and that's it, and it almost doesn't come from anywhere, hasn't developed an idea. And what I'm trying to do my best with here is that lead you and help you through a project right from the start and to the end. Now, with all good projects at the start, we all need to come up with a number of ideas to start off with, and then we can start eliminating some of them that aren't so good and then bringing the ones that are forward. So the name of this project is going to be called My Surroundings, and there's a number of reasons why I've called it that. One of the main reasons is that being your surroundings, it's wherever you are at the time. So if that's home, then brilliant. You can have lots of things that you can look at, create observational drawings from, and also have that primary information instead of relying on the internet. Especially if some people don't have the internet, then that's going to be obviously the main issue. Secondly, it also covers the four main areas that I feel a lot of art is. The first one is objects. So you might want to do daily routine, something that you wake up in the morning, you might be brushing your teeth, washing your hair, or maybe just having your breakfast, having a cup of coffee. Those objects and things that you're using and engaging with, you can actually do some drawings from. You also might live with some other people, so you might want to decide to take it along the route of doing some portraiture or human form. Looking into your local community or local area, you might want to look outside and see the urban or the rural environment and do some drawings from there, maybe on some local daily walks. And finally, some abstract work. If you decide that you don't really want to do something that is photorealistic or maybe observational, then you might want to look at patterns within your local area or inside the home. That could well be looking at wallpaper. It could also be looking at design of windows or pavements or grids. There's lots and lots of things to choose from. And so I feel like it's quite, you know, open, but also you have to be open-minded and really investigate what you want to draw and find things quite interesting. Remember, the most mundane things that you can think of sometimes end up being the most exciting paintings and drawings that you'll ever do. So I'm going to get myself set up. There's a number of things that you will need. Very, very simply, you'll need some images. These images can come from the internet if you have got an internet and a printer, or a newspaper, a magazine, or maybe just packaging itself. I want you to collect a number of different things that relate to one of those topics that I've just discussed. You'll need some scissors, some glue or sellotape, or maybe some masking tape, and maybe a piece of paper to put it on. See you in a minute.
Okay, so ready to start. And as you see, first of all, I'm putting a 1 centimeter border around the page. This is just for presentation purposes. Now, the next thing that you're going to see is that I've got some images printed out already. And these are things from maybe your daily routine, such as brushing your teeth, your toothpaste, maybe your breakfast cereal, or if you like a coffee or a tea. And I thought they'd be quite nice on some of the artists that I've looked at here, as George Shaw paintings, such as the goalposts, and then obviously books for hobbies. Here I've got is Michael Craig Martin. He does a lot of objects. So I've got a game console, a TV, some lipstick and headphones. And then I've also got Audrey Flack, who did Vanitas, looking at a lot of objects that to do with a lot of meaning. Here I've got Patrick Caulfield, artist that looked at interiors, which is quite a nice thing to look at. Again, I've got George Shaw there, and I've also got Edward Hopper, who did work to do with isolation, which would be really poignant during these times. Another thing that I've probably got here, I've got some things from inside your fridge. So you can maybe draw some objects that you have in maybe inside your fridge there. And the last thing that I've actually got some cuttings from newspapers and magazines. So you might be lucky and find some really cool images here. Here's just an example of showing the games console before. You might actually find an image in the newspaper. This is just an opening, so I like the window in there, so I might take that for my collage page. And this last one is using pattern. So if you want to do some abstract, think about where you'd might be get some elements from that. And the last one is the chairs, which reminds me of Patrick Caulfield. Now, this task is all about placement of images, and it's your kind of your first page in a sketchbook, really. If you ever heard of a mind map before, this is exactly the same, but you're doing a visual mind map. Okay, so you're trying to be inventive and creative how you're placing all the images. So you might cut around them, you might layer them on top of each other, and you might also put them into categories. So you'll see here on the left-hand side, I've got the morning routine. The bottom left-hand side is all everything to do with inside, maybe rooms. It could be objects inside those rooms. Right-hand side is to do with hobbies, such as reading or playing football. And as you see there, I've got Mactown, that was in the local newspaper. And before sticking any of them down, you just want to make sure you're happy with the placement of them. You know, there's always a better way of arranging things. So try and not work out on your first one and just make sure you're happy with them. Once you've done that, you're going to stick them all down. Make sure you stick right up to the edges so you don't have any dog-eared areas and it's all nice and smooth and neat. And once you've done that, then we're going to move on to the next stage, which is all about adding some little bit of information and annotation towards those images. So the first thing I'm going to annotate here is, as I said before, was the daily routine. So anything to do with my daily routine, just as soon as you get up in the morning, what things are you interacting with, such as maybe the remote control for your TV in the morning, or maybe it's just a kettle. Anything that you're interacting with or has impact on your day, you might want to take a picture of it, or maybe it could be an object that you want to draw. Now, as I'm carry on writing, and I have written furniture there, so, you know, you've got your bed, you've got your sofa, you've got your kitchen room chairs, those types of things. And then we're moving on to hobbies. So what hobbies do you have? Have you got any comics, maybe, instead of reading books? You know, it could be drawing some of the characters inside those magazines or comics. So you've got to really investigate to what you're interested in, but there's going to be tons and tons of things around. Now, as I keep on annotating the things here, joining up elements that are tying together, such as they've got hobbies, football and gaming, and I've looked at Michael Craig Martin for his game console. I'm also looking at maybe the view from outside. What is your view from outside? Is it interesting? It might not be to you, but have a think about how you could do it from a different angle. You might want to go outside and then have a bit of a walk around your local area. You might want to see maybe, it could be wildlife, it could be plant life and nature. So literally you've got to be looking what you feel that you're drawn to, and that's what we're going to kind of latch onto it. I always say to students, this is like the spark of the sketchbook, okay? You know, if you're igniting a fire, you need that spark. And without this page, you're not going to be able to get that spark going. So remember, you are able to put images on here that you're not necessarily going to take further than this page, but it just gives you options for the future. If it was me and I was looking on here, obviously, I'm interested in objects in the landscape, so it might be the telephone box or even the goalpost and things like that. I find them quite interesting. And I see here what I'm doing is just drawing over the top of the images. I'm just making it my own, to be honest, kind of almost laminating the image with the page and making it a little bit more interesting and a little bit more bespoke. Here I've just done a drawing of a coffee cup. I thought I'd just maybe fill in some of the white spaces. Remember, you want to try and make it as compact as you possibly can, just making you fill in all the little spaces, whether it be annotation or drawings. It just makes it look like you've investigated quite a lot. Now, as I keep on tidying up areas, neating and maybe putting boxes around them just so they stand out, I'm also thinking about adding a little bit more information. Do you know, why am I drawn to these pieces? And then it'll give me some indication if they are, you know, an interesting idea in the future. Now, to finish off, or you could actually do this at the start if you want to, I'm just going to write using a stencil because it's a little bit easier. I'm going to write the words my surroundings, because obviously all the images today that I've used are from either my surroundings or you would be in the normal suburban kind of surrounding setting.
Well, that's it, guys, for the video. Hopefully you found it informative. Hopefully you found it interesting. It was very simplistic. No drawing was required on this double page. It was just literally just to get your ideas on the page and help, hopefully, inspired you to go into a certain direction in the future. Just remember, if you have got any empty space in the pages, feel free to keep on adding those in there and maybe add some keywords or maybe look up on a thesaurus and try and find some other words that relate to it. It might spur you on to try and find some extra ideas in there. Anyway, I'll leave it there until the next video. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I haven't said that in a while. And yeah, look forward to seeing you on the next video. See you later, guys.